Overnight while on a trip through Texas Hill Country more than 6 months ago. The couple's vehicle was reportedly recovered near Cypress Mill last November, but no further evidence has been unearthed until now. Police say a wallet and pocketbook containing IDs matching the husband and wife were found scattered near the Pedernales River. The couple's whereabouts are still unknown. New details have emerged in the grisly string of murders that littered Interstate 40 during 1971 and 72. Known only as the Terror of I-40, authorities say an unidentified woman spent years hitchhiking from Texas to California, where she viciously murdered several truck drivers and three other young women along the route. Billy Jasper of Winslow, Arizona, claims he likely had an encounter with the assailant at his home over a year ago. Jasper says a young woman in her 20s approached his home seeking water and food, but after a few minutes, the woman allegedly became irate with Mr. Jasper's line of questioning. Eventually, the unidentified female started to attack Jasper with a razor blade. He was able to defend himself until he was...
Get through. What's that? Locked. Damn it. I have to find the others.
Thank you.
Adolescent vandals have been terrorizing the city of Lexington, Texas, with horrific depictions of famine and the macabre. Nearby active officers may involve remote Odessa sheriffs investigating evidence authorities locally intercepted years ago. The grotesque animal dioramas composed of fox bones have appeared in the two cities, yet their connection is unknown, but not likely coincidental. The youths are believed to be sisters. Authorities cannot confirm nor deny potential lineage. Citizens are encouraged to report any findings to the police. The man believed to be responsible for multiple stranglings in East Texas is finally in custody tonight. Authorities...
This will help. find something I can use. Connie! You're still alive! I don't know what this is. It might work on those doors. They're here. I need to hide. Just go away, damn it. I can't get away. Think. What was that thing? Was that a person? Why won't they leave me alone? I'm good. Just stay calm. What's that? They're too close. I think they left. Who the hell are these people? Just go, let me
go. If you're feeling it, it's holding you back.
Brutal attack on three female college students in Pflugerville, Texas last year is back in the public spotlight. Pflugerville citizens are in an uproar demanding answers from Texas state officials on why no arrests have been made in the case. Reports say an unidentified man entered the home in the middle of the night, viciously strangling one female to death before attempting to stab both roommates who were sleeping nearby. Authorities believe the attacker fled the scene after discovering multiple people lived in the house. The man is believed to be in his late 20s, has dark hair and brown eyes, and has several scars on his face.
Stay strong. Gotta find the others. Damn these freaks. I hope the others are okay.
Continue to plague the quiet farming communities of Central Texas as two more were reported just last evening. The cows were discovered with the throat slit and cut from belly to hip. Officials believe multiple perpetrators are responsible as the mutilations appear to have been committed at the same time. The Sheriff's Department advises all ranchers to patrol their property, heavily armed, and report any suspicious activity. Local farmer Devereaux Lateague told local reporters that he believes it is the work of, quote, devil worshippers. Authorities have not yet responded for comment on that claim. Authorities were alerted to Hellum's ranch yesterday to investigate reports of cattle abuse, but what they found instead was disturbingly serene. The ranch was devoid of livestock. Instead, 13 men, all dressed in plain white clothes, were sitting in chairs spread throughout the property. Each one was wearing a simple rope belt, a pair of sunglasses, and holding a copy of King James' Bible. No man showed signs of abuse, neglect, or trauma. The sheriff's department believes each man ingested some amount of potassium cyanide, judging from the large quantities of it discovered in the kitchen. No reason has been given as to why these men may have taken their lives.
Please, please don't let that thing come back. What's that? Fit in the door. can get
there,
through.
Sweet child. I can help you. Just come over here. There's things in this house I just can't let you see, darling.
But it's something.
Where is everybody? Oh, this is awful.
Where is it exactly you think you're going?
Why are you doing this to me? Stop.
Okay.
You can do that.
I got it.
Please, God, help me.
Everywhere I turn, there they are.
Well, ain't you shifty?
Stay away from me.
Thank you.